One of the reasons why I love building new things or tinkering around with projects is I get to find new ways to solve problems, and then I get to learn if that's the best way to solve it, and then I get to share it with you. And when I put out my Laracasts course about 6 months back or so, I came across this problem that I had, specifically with how to redirect back to a page that someone was at before they wanted to log in or register or create an account. And here's a solution I came up with. Is this the best solution? I don't know. Let's figure it out. Okay, let's say you have a project, and this is the project that I built in the Laracasts course. If you haven't seen that, it's in the description below. It is a paid course through Laracasts, but it was so much fun building it and just learning new things. Mostly it's a lot of live wire, a lot of Alpine. But when you are in this page to listen to a podcast together, like if I was to go out and come back into this, it automatically starts playing. But here is one neat thing that I had some trouble figuring out what's the best way to solve this. If I want to click login to chat, well, it directs me to the login page, or it takes me to the register page, I should say, because that's typical. If you have not created an account, usually the register page is the best option. Well, what if you have created an account? I've already registered. Well, now I want to log in, but if I click login, where are we redirecting? I mean, we can't really redirect back to the dashboard. That wasn't where they were last, because then let's say they go back to the dashboard, then they have to click back into the page that they were in to be logged back in. Well, here's the way that I solve this. Again, I don't know if this is the best way to do this, and there's probably easier ways to do it, but it's the way that made most sense to me, and it was actually rather. Okay, when we're in a listening party, I want to redirect or authenticate the user. Now, again, it's redirecting by default to the register page, because that's usually where you would go if you don't have an account within this application. So I have this public function authenticate user. Let's see if we can find the button where we do the login to chat button. We send people use the wire click to authenticate user. Now, what does this authenticate user does? Real quick, I'm using the voltage plugin to be able to jump back up to this. Makes it super easy. The authenticate user is going to in the session, put this auth redirect that is specific to this route. So I'm just basically putting something into the session, which is the auth redirect, and I'm putting that using, and again, session is specific to an individual user. So it's not necessarily something that's being stored in the cache for all users. It's just in the session. So in session, we're going to put auth redirect and the route that user is currently on, and then we're redirecting to the register route. So again, what does session do? Well, it keeps that in the session until the next page load. So this is where it gets a little tricky. And I think the Laravel session automatically does this. If you're redirecting someplace that you need authentication, it should redirect back, but that only is for one page. So if we redirect to register and we register, it will automatically go back, no problem. But what happens if we need to click on login and then we're logging in? Well, it redirects back to register, which then you're already registered, so it redirects to dashboard by default. You can, of course, change that, but how do we get to where we put this into the session? Well, here's the way I came up with it. I came up with a middleware that I put in the all of the apps middlewares on app.php. I have this middleware that is appended persist auth redirect. What's happening here? I'm basically just saying that if the session has an auth redirect, then we're going to keep it. If it doesn't have an auth redirect, and then we're just going to return next. So what's happening in the login then? Well, we're redirecting and we're pulling the auth redirect section so that we can redirect them to the next place that they need to go, because that's typically where I needed to keep that session pulled for the user. Because again, if they go to register, we're just going to automatically log them in and push them back to the where they were. And I believe I also put this in register as well. So in register, yes, we're also pulling the auth redirect route and pushing that in. But in login, I'm pulling it as well. And that's the only two places that I need it, because that's my authentication pages. So again, this is probably extremely simple, extremely basic, but it's something that I didn't necessarily think of, and I had to do a little bit of digging into, okay, what am I actually trying to do? And what I was trying to do is keep this specific route, in this case, a specific listening party route. I wanted to keep that available so that I knew where to direct the user. So maybe you have specific projects where you're learning stuff like this. You're learning, okay, I need this particular action to happen, but how am I going to make that work? And yes, maybe this isn't the best use case. Maybe there are specific things that are in the Laravel framework that I don't know about. Maybe there are things that could be in the Laravel framework that would be great to solve this particular problem of having to log in, but I'm already registered, so I want to actually register. And of course, you could fix this with UI, say log in to chat or maybe register to chat, and then you're not having to figure out which one is which, but I wanted to make it as easy as possible for the users, and that middleware made it easy. So whatever you're doing, whatever you're learning, whatever you're building, maybe you can find a little thing like I did. So keep creating.